Hello, all of you. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So last time we were doing this Michaelis-Pitts model. We finished with AND and OR gate, and we saw by both the methods, right? One method was straightforward, by which we used to make the firing and inhibition, and then used to draw the graph, and then used to calculate this equation yin is equal to w1 x1 plus w2 x2, right? So for all the patterns we used to calculate, and initially we used to assume w1 and w2 weights. So this is one method, and another method was by writing this kind of logic, and then by making the equation, and then validate by assume certain values, and then try to validate all the four equations. So if all the four equations are getting validated, then that means assume value is right, and this answer may vary from one student to another student. Now let's see another gate, that is NOT gate. So I am implementing by the second method, and you know that for NOT gate, 0 will be 1 for firing condition, 1 will be 0 for inhibition condition. And if you see, the rules will be what? Only one input is there, so I am taking only one weight. Okay, so I'm writing wx is greater than theta for firing condition, so I'll be deciding certain threshold value. So I'm saying wx is greater than theta firing condition, and wx less than equal to theta inhibition condition, right? So if this is greater, then another one will be less than equal to theta, right? This is for inhibition. So it's up to you. If you are making this as greater than equal to theta, then the another one will be what? Less than theta, right? Or if this is what, less than theta, then this one will be greater than equal to theta. So it's up to you which rule, equation rule you are following. So if I have decided this particular thing, then I'll try to assume some values. So let's assume w equal to theta equal to -1, and then if I try to find out, so this will be what? X is what? 0 multiplied by w is what? -1. So -1 is greater than -1. Okay, first one will be 0, sorry, because this input is 0. So 0 is greater than -1. Yes, the first equation is getting validated, and the second equation is what? Wx less than equal to theta. So w we have assumed -1, x is 1, so that means -1 less than equal to theta. Yeah, theta is what? Theta is -1, so it's less than equal to theta. It's equal to theta. So both the equations are getting validated. That means w equal to theta equal to -1 is what? Assumption is right. And then we can draw this particular our circuit, and we can write the equation also. Okay, so this is for the NOT gate. Just all of you note down this NOT gate. So which problem is important in this? The one problem is there, that is XOR gate, that is very important. So we will see now.
So this method for NOT gate that you just explained, this is using the second method, right? The
right, second method.
So how would you solve it with the first method?
Then simply you will have to calculate yin is equal to wx, right? By writing the formula. Just 1 minute, one note. Just 1 minute. Okay. So what I'll say over here, y in is equal to wx. Okay, so this will be my equation, because I am having only one gate, one node, and this is my W, this is my X, and here I am collecting Y in, and this will give me the Y output. Okay, so the Y in will be, Y in formula will be WX. Now I am assuming that W is equal to X is equal to minus 1, let's say. So if I am assuming this one, I'll have to first draw the table, right? So for 0, 1, here I am writing 1, 0. So this is my X and this is my output Y. So first one is my firing condition and this one is my inhibition condition. Then I'll try to calculate. Okay, so first case one, where I assumed W is equal to X is equal to minus 1. So first, for the first value X equal to 0, I'll try to calculate. So what is my Y in? Y in I'm calculating, Y in will be what? It's WX, right? Y in is equal to WX. So my W is what? Minus 1. And X is what? X is 0. So Y in will be 0. And then when X is equal to 1, I'll calculate Y in is equal to, so WX, right? W is what? Minus 1. W is minus 1. And my X is, sorry, this is theta, sorry. Okay. So here we don't have to assume theta, right? In the first method, we don't have to assume theta, only we have to assume W. So we don't have to assume theta. And this here, X is what? 1. So 1 into W is what? Minus 1. So here I will get minus 1. So I got two values. One is 0. Another is minus 1, right? So now we have to assume some threshold value, that is Y in, okay? A threshold value which will going to separate both these conditions. So if I'll assume that if my Y in is greater than equal to 0, then the output will be 1. Else less than 0, output will be 0. So by this way, I can design my circuit. Whether you understood this first method?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, but in this, for the NOT gate, we don't have to draw a graph and show linear separability.
You can draw the graph. You can draw the graph also, right?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, you can draw the graph also. No issue at all. So, it will be linearly separable. Only two classes are there. Clear cut two classes are there. Okay. So, but this will not come on these two axes. Okay. So that's why I have not drawn over there, because only one input is there. Yeah. So that thing is there. Hello. All of you are hearing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's go to. Yeah, there is one. There is one gate and not. So write the question. Design and not using Mac-Lockwitz model. Use binary data representation. Use binary data representation. And not. So the and not gate is what? If the when it will fire, if the first input is true and second input is false, in that case only it will going to fire. So remember this thing. If the first input is true and the second input is false, then only it will going to fire. So we have to draw, we have to first draw this particular table. So all of you draw this table, X1, Y.
So what is this and not? Or we have to remember this table.
Yes.
Is it
yes.
And then not, or it is something different?
I don't think it's and then you will take the not, then it will come.
because if we see
Yeah,
the
that
AND,
will cause
f for AND,
anyone.
this will be 1 1, this will be output 1, right? And then if you take the negative of
Yes,
that,
yes.
so this will become 0 and there should be 1. So this is not exactly same as AND and then taking the NOT. So there is one AND NOT gate, okay? The term is used AND NOT, and this is having some other combinational logic circuit. I don't know the exact combination logic circuit, but this problem is mentioned. So all of you, you are from that this digital logic circuit thing. So you can just check out this AND NOT full expression, okay? So it's not
Okay,
the
sir.
same. It's not the same as AND and then after taking NOT. Okay. So if this is the case, 1 0 and 1. Now we have to see clearly that there are two different classes. So this is our firing condition. So after assumption and after calculation, we should be able to separate out this particular case with the rest of the cases. Okay, so let's assume first. So we have written the formula y1 is equal to w1 x1 plus w2 x2. And we have assumed what w1 is equal to 1 and w2 is equal to 1. So let's try to calculate for each pair what will be the y-in. So we have written over here first one is 1 1, 1 0, 0 1 and 0 0. Remember for this one, okay, for this one where the first input is true, second input is false, in that case we should get what firing condition. So that means 1 0 pattern is there. Now let's calculate. So for 1 1 we are getting what y-in is equal to 2. This is our firing condition. So 1 0, for 1 0 we are getting 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1, that is 1. Then 0 1 for 0 1 we are getting 1. For 0 0 we are getting 0. Now just by seeing at y in output, you all can tell that whether it's possible to separate out the firing condition with rest of the three condition by selecting certain threshold value. Just think on that.
No, sir.
Yeah, can we separate out this particular case? No, because if you see here clearly that, let's say suppose I'm making any assumption greater than equal to 1, then this will also come and this condition will also be included. If I say less than equal to 1, then less than 1 or less than equal to 1, then this will come, but along with this one is also there, even 0 is there, right? Equal to 1 if I'll take, then the another one more condition is there. So we are not able to separate it out from rest of the three cases. That means what? It indicates that whatever weights we have assumed for calculation purpose, that is w1 is equal to w2, that is wrong. So we will assume next. So we'll go for the next case where we will assume w1 equal to 1 and w2 equal to minus 1. Okay, simply we are negating one of the weight. So now we are assuming that one as an excitatory signal, another one as inhibitory signal. And then we will try to calculate whether for w1 is equal to 1 and w2 equal to minus 1, it's working or not. So, whether till here all of you completed?
No, sir. Can you just scroll up a little bit?
Yeah, what is that? Lecture कर लूँ मैं, हाँ उसके बाद, ठीक है? आधा एक घंटा बैठ, ठीक है? तब तक तुम drawing बनाओ कुछ तो, हाँ. Archana, what you were saying? Scroll.
No, sir, it is fine. Now you're I can note it down.
So in this particular method, we always see if we practice it. So in the start only you might be knowing that if I'll assume this particular weight for this one, it's correct. Okay. For example, if in the exam AND NOT will come and you have already practiced, so in the start only you can assume w1 equal to 1, w2 equal to minus 1, and you will get the full marks. Doesn't matter, okay? So if you're directly assuming w1 equal to 1, w2 equal to minus 1, and if you are able to solve it correctly, obviously you will get the marks, full marks. So it's up to you. If you practice, if you remember, you can directly assume. I'll tell you where we have to show that no, the first assume weight is wrong, and then we will assume for the next one. When it's for, let's say, for 10 marks, 15 marks, right? For 10 marks, so it's better we can show over there. 5 marks, no need to show at all. Okay, no need to show at all the wrong weights. Okay, we can directly assume the right weights. If it's for the 10 marks, then we can show that first condition is false, and then we are going for the second condition. So only thing, it will increase the length. Completed till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, since we were not able to separate it out, this second case from the rest of the cases, the second case was the firing condition. That's why we assume the weights now W1 equal to 1 and W2 equal to minus 1. Now we'll try to calculate for this W1 equal to 1, W2 equal to minus 1. So, first pattern we took 1, 1, and we are calculating Yin is equal to. Okay, any doubt in this calculation, how I am calculating? I'm simply following the formula Yin is equal to W1 X1 plus W2 X2, and I am simply substituting the values. And these two pairs are what? That is X1 and X2, and W we have assumed. So we can simply substitute the values and we can calculate. So for 1, 1, 1, 1, I am getting Yin is equal to 0. For 1, 0, Yin is equal to 1, I am getting. For 0, 1, Yin is equal to minus 1, and for 0, 0, Yin is equal to 0. Now we have to check for 1, 0 pattern, okay, that was there in our table as a firing condition. First input 2, second input false, then it should give 1 output. So for this particular case, whether now it's possible to separate it out by simply choosing one of the threshold value with the rest of the cases, so we have to find out this. So if you see here clearly that one output is 0, another is also 0, and one is minus 1. So if we try to choose greater than 0, okay, or let's say greater than equal to 1, both will work, and then we can easily separate out this the second case with the rest of the three cases. So here, after changing the weights, we could separate it out. That means assume weight is what? Correct. So the final weight will be what? W equal to 1 and W2 equal to minus 1. So we can write the equation over here, that y equal to f of yn equal to 1, if yn is greater than equal to 1, so we have taken 1 as what threshold value, and less than 1, 0. And then finally you can draw the circuit also, okay? You can draw the circuit and you can write the weights. In this problem, any doubt is there, so you can ask me. And not get, you can refer, you can Google it, and then you will get the basic combination circuit of that one. So for AND not gate, remember the first input is true and the second input is false, then only it gives one output.
So in questions like AND not or not, we would first take AND of X1 and not of X2.
Maybe, yeah, that may give the output. Okay.
So we should not take AND of X1, X2, then not it.
It's not exactly the AND and then after that not. I told you it's not exactly that one. Okay, so there is some difference between AND not and this AND, taking AND and then, so AND not will be basically your NAND, right?
Yeah.
So it's not NAND gate. Yeah.
Okay, so got
not
it.
A NAND gate. Yeah. This example is taken because if you try to assume the values 1, 1, then in this particular case you will not get the proper output. Okay, so that's why we have to change the way. So one of the signal, if you take the NEBT, then we are getting the output. Okay. So if you all of you completed, then we can go to the next problem. In the next week, I am thinking to keep one guest lecture from one of our alumni who is there in machine learning, and he's working as a data scientist. So I told him to take one lecture, that is how to become a data scientist. Okay, the steps to become the data scientist. And then I requested him to take one part of a convolutional neural network, where he can take one application, okay, any business application of convolutional neural network. So he'll be taking one application from the Google, and he'll be explaining that based on the convolutional neural network. and then the steps to become data scientist. So I was thinking to keep one lecture for 1 hour or 1.5 hour. So most probably I'll try to keep on next Friday, because in next week, I think till Monday, Tuesday, you are having some placement, I think. Placement test is there. So whether Friday and all will be okay for all of you? And whatever inputs you want to, whatever question you want to ask, you can always ask. And it's a good thing that somebody is coming from the industry and you can directly ask a question, okay? So he may be able to guide you, all of you. Getting my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Now this problem will already we have done. Yeah, there is XOR. So this problem requires a little bit concentration, so do it carefully. Now let's start this, write this question. Implement XOR function using McCulloch-Pitts neuron, consider binary data. Okay, consider binary data. Okay, why it's written in the bracket, the consider binary data? Because in the exam, they may give it consider bipolar data. So if they will give you bipolar data, then at that time you will have to take in place of 0 as -1. Okay, please remember this. So if in the bracket it's given, use bipolar data, you will have to take what? -1 in place of 0. If it's binary data, then you can take 0 and 1. So that changes you will have to do. So always you will have to consider in everything 0 as what? -1. So write this, implement XOR function using McCulloch-Pitts neuron, consider binary data. So for XOR, the table is like this. For 0, 1, and 1, 0, we'll be getting 1 output. Okay. For dissimilar inputs, we are getting 1. And for 0, 0, 1, 1, we are getting 0 output. So this is our table. Okay. Now after this, we will try to draw that graph. Okay. So if we'll try to draw the graph, let's try to draw the graph. 0, 0, we will get 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, and for 1, 1, 0. So if I am having x1, x2, so first one is 0, 0, 0, I am getting 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, I am getting 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, I'm getting 0. Now, so if we try to separate it out by one single line, it's not possible to separate it out, okay? So this is not a linearly separable problem. It's not a linearly separable problem, okay? Because we are not able to separate it out by one single straight line. Okay, then after that, what we can do? So here I've written something like, in this case, the output is on for only odd number of ones. For the rest, it is off. So XOR function cannot be represented by simple logic function. it is represented as y is equal to x1 x2 bar plus x1 bar x2. Okay, x1 x2 bar plus x1 bar x2. So I hope all of you can understand this particular notation. Where we used to do in digital logic circuit like this, y is equal to x1 x2 bar plus x1 bar x2. So this function cannot be implemented by simple logic function. It can be implemented by this kind of function. So what we can do, we can write this first part as z1 and the second part as z2. So y can be represented as what? Y is equal to z1 plus z2. Okay. Y can be represented as z1 plus z2. So where your z1 is x1 x2 bar, and your z2 is what? x1 bar x2. So two functions are there, and then finally we have to take what? Or. So where y we can be generated by taking z1 or z2. So these three things we have to implement now. Z1 is equal to x1 x2 bar, z2 equal to x1 bar x2, and then y will be equal to z1 or z2. So if we try to calculate this z1 or z2, you will get the same output like this: 0 1 1 0. Completed, all of you? Okay, after this. So a single layer net is not sufficient to represent the function. So an intermediate layer is necessary. So if you see here, till now we have not used any intermediate layer, but here we are using two layers, that is Z1 and Z2. I mean, one layer we are, this thing we are implementing, in that two neurons are there, Z1 and Z2. Okay, so this layer is coming in between input layer and the output layer. So we are adding one extra layer to solve this particular problem. So here what we are doing, we are just simply drawing it. So the first one is x1 x2 input. So this x1 is coming, x2 is coming over here. Then we have taken z1 and z2, right? From middle layer to the y, we are taking weights as v1 and v2, and from input to the hidden layer, we are taking the weights as what? Our normal rotation, like W11, W12, then W21 and W22. This one also you can take if you want V1, because here on Y there is no this thing is there, Y1 or Y2, that's why it's written like this, V1 and V2. So just draw this circuit. Simply for the x, from the x1 just connect both the neurons, from x2 also connect both the neurons. For giving the notation, you can write weights and then this number from you can start from the input to the hidden layer. So the first number will be of the input, that is 1, and second one is of z. Similarly, if you see here this one, the w12, first one of the input and second one 2 is from z2. Okay, so w12. this one, if you see a W, 2, 1. 2 is of X and 1 is of Z. So let's start with the first function, that is z1 is equal to. So I told you that we will going to solve first one by this, I mean first z1 is equal to x1 x2 bar, then second we will try to solve z2 is equal to x1 bar x2, and the third we will take the complete whole function z1 or z2. So let's solve this particular z is equal to x1 x2 bar. Okay, so the first function z1 is equal to x1 x2 bar, the truth table for z1 is shown below. So what is this truth table? We will take first x1 and x2, then we will take x2 bar, and then we will multiply, we'll take the AND. Okay, so let's do it. So if we will take the x2 bar, so 0 1 1 0, okay, 0 1 and 1 0. Now we will take the AND of this x1 and x2 bar. If we take it 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 sorry 1 1, okay, I saw this one 1 1 1, and then the last one 1 0 0. So for this particular case we are getting what firing condition. So which is that pattern? 1 0 1 1. Okay, so for 1 1 we are getting what firing condition, and for rest of the cases we are getting 0 0 0. So let's try to solve, and let's try to assume the weights and try to solve whether we are getting the proper value, proper condition to separate it out or not. So case one we are taking, and we are just drawing the part of that particular circuit, that is still Z1, because this is a Z1. So we will going to draw only this particular part. X1 is connected to Z1 and X2 is also connected to Z1. X1 is connected to Z1 by W11 weight. X2 is connected to Z1 by W21 weight. So we will take only this particular part, and X1 is coming over here, X2 is coming over here. So if you see the circuit, X1, X2, X1 is connected by W11 to Z1, X2 is connected to Z1 by W21. So what will be the total net input at Z1? Z1 in, denoted by Z1 input. Z1 in is equal to X1 into W11 plus X2 into W21. Okay, and now we will solve. Let's assume that W11 is equal to W21 is equal to 1, right? That is W11 is equal to 1, W21 is equal to both the weights, both these weights we are assuming as 1, and let's try to calculate what is the Z in 1. Okay, Z in 1. So for these patterns 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1 we will try to solve it. So if you see, if we will solve for these patterns, what output we will be getting? So Z1 in we are getting 0, Z1 in for this one 0 1 we are getting 1, for 1 0 we are getting 1, and for 1 1 we are getting 2. Now for this particular pattern 1 0, for this one it should give us what? 1. So, but for here, it is not possible to obtain function Z1 using these waves, because if you try to separate the threshold, the other two values are 1, 0, this is also 1, and then 1 value is 2. So if I take greater than 1, greater than equal to 1, so this will also come in that, and this will come definitely. But if I select less than equal to 1, then this will come and other two will also come. If I'll take equal to 1, then the second condition will also come. So it's not satisfying. So that means whatever weights we assume, that is not correct. So what we can do, we can assume one weight as W11 as 1 and W21 as minus 1. So that means this weight as minus 1 and this weight as what? 1. Now if we will do that and we'll try to calculate, for 0, 0 we are getting 0. For 0, 1, we are getting minus 1. And for 1, 0, we are getting what? 1, and for 1, 1, we are getting as what? 0. So for 1, 0, if we see here, for 1, 0, we are getting what? 1. And for 1, 0, we wanted to separate it out because that was our firing condition. So after selection of proper weights, we should be able to separate it out from the rest of the three cases. So here, if I'll select my threshold as greater than equal to 1, Z in 1, if I'll select greater than equal to 1, then I'll be able to easily separate it out by rest of the three cases. That means whatever weights we assume W1 equal to 1 and W2 1 is equal to minus 1, that is correct. So our assumption is right. Okay. So here I have written W11 is equal to 1 and W21 is equal to minus 1, where theta I have taken as what? Greater than equal to 1 for Z1 neuron. So I hope you understood why we have taken theta is equal to greater than equal to 1, or you can say Z in 1 is greater than equal to 1, because we wanted to separate it out this particular case with the rest of the cases, and this is our firing condition. Now after this is completed, so our these weights are fixed. Now W11 is equal to 1 and W21 is equal to minus 1. Now we can choose the second function, Z2 is equal to X1 bar X2. So we are taking now this one. So first we will draw these inputs, and then we will take X1 bar, and then we will take the AND, and we will get what? Z2 output. Now we will draw the only the part of that particular circuit for Z2. So for the Z2, we will see which circuit is connected. So for Z2, X1 is connected by W12 and X2 is connected by W22. So we will only draw this particular part of the circuit. Okay, so see, if you see here, Z2 is connected from X1 by W12 and from X2 by W22. Now here also we will first going to assume, let's say W12 equal to W22 equal to 1, and we will try to calculate Z in 2, what is the net input at this Z2. So if we try to calculate all these patterns, okay, and which is the firing condition, this 0 1, this pattern is should give what firing condition, the second one. So let's see here. So after calculation with this W1 equal to W22 equal to 1 weight, we are getting that output as what? 0, 1, 1 and 2. So for this second condition, we should get a firing condition. But with the second condition, we are not able to separate it out after selecting proper threshold, because two are same only, right? These two conditions same only. If I'll try to take greater than equal to 1, so this will also come, and this will also come, third one, and the fourth one will also come. Less than equal to 1, then this will also come, and the zero condition, zero output will also come. Okay, so by choosing these weights, W12 equal to W22 equal to 1, we are not able to separate it out. So that means whatever assumption we made, that is not correct. So what we can do, we can assume one weight as inhibitory, another weight as, see, it's not necessary that you will always, whenever it's not matching, you will always going to assume one weight as what, negative, and another weight as positive. You can assume any weights. This is trial and error method. You're supposed to get the proper separation of the condition, right? But this is what I mean, since we know that, so there is no point in assuming different weights and just prolong your answers, okay? So, because after solving this, I'll tell you that for the XOR gates, if the cross weights are there, you can directly assume those as minus 1. So for example, W12, W2, if you'll assume minus 1, W11, W22 as plus 1, then you will get directly the output, proper output, okay? So just for getting 10 marks and increasing the page size, okay, we are just assuming first one as 1, 1, and then we are trying to show that we are not getting from the first one. Then with the second, we are assuming, and then we are getting the output. Okay, so that depends on your time, and if you're having enough time, you can do this. If you don't have time, you can show for one case. If for the first one, you can show the case, and then directly you can assume 1 and minus 1, or even if you are doing directly, then also you will get the full marks. So for then we will try to assume one weight W12, that is, this is the cross weight we are assuming as -1, W22 is equal to 1. And now we will try to calculate. So if we try to calculate for the second pattern, you are getting as what? 1 output. All of you there? All of you listening?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yes, sir. Okay. I thought I got disconnected or what? Okay. So for the second pattern, we are getting 1. Now if we see, if you try to find out the threshold value, and if you select greater than equal to 1, so we can easily separate it out the second case with the rest of the cases. So that means we can say that the W12 equal to -1 and W22 equal to 1, and theta, or you can take Z2 in as greater than equal to 1. This is a proper condition. Now after this, the third function is what? Our third function is y is equal to z1 or z2. Okay, z1 or z2. So now we will have to do this one. Till here, all of you please do it, and then we can go ahead. So please, till here, all of you complete it. First, try to solve for both the function. Okay, z1 and z2. So till here, you just complete, all of you. Try to solve by your own, so you'll be able to understand it. If you're having any doubt, please ask me. Done?
No, sir, we are doing it.
Okay.
how did you build the two table for the third function? Can you explain that part?
This one, right? So
yes,
we
sir, for the third function, truth table.
So we wrote Z1 and Z2, okay, output.
Okay, sir.
And we took the OR of that one.
Yeah, but how we took the values of Z1 and Z2? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then again 0, 0, and not 1, 1.
So these Z1 and Z2 values are there, right? These Z1 and Z2 values are there.
Okay, we have taken the output values of both Z1 and Z2.
Yeah, because we are working on this, man. See, Y is equal to Z1 or Z2, okay? So we have taken the output of Z1, and we have taken the output because we divided that entire function into Z1 and Z2 part. And I told you that the third function will be what? The addition of, I mean, the OR of both, right? We wrote somewhere here.
Yes, sir.
This one. Yeah. Yes, so this sir, is what, yes, now the final function, this one. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Finished till here.
Yes,
so after, yeah, so after both the functions, you can just go for the third one. And the third one is easy, Y is equal to Z1 or Z2, and you can make the first table. Right? Now here, if you see, you can draw now the entire circuit of this Z1 or Z2. So where if you see, let's see the circuit first. This one, okay, so we are now concentrating on this one. So Z1 is coming over here and Z2 is coming up to Y, and we are getting the Y output. Now if we have to calculate total Y in at this particular point, right? So V1 weight and by V2 weight both are connected. So let's see that one. So we can write Y is equal to, formula will be Z1 V1 plus Z2 V2. Z1 V1 plus Z2 V2. Now we'll try to calculate and we will see. So we are assuming that the weights are V1 is equal to V2 is equal to 1. And for these two cases, we should get what? Firing condition. So for 0, 0, we will calculate, we are getting what? 0. For 0, 1, we are calculating and we are getting 1. Then for 1, 0, we are calculating, we are getting 1. For 1, 1, we are getting what? 0. Don't take these cases, I mean the same pattern, okay? We have to take what? Our original pattern, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So don't get confused in this one. This we have drawn for Z1, Z2, Z1 or Z2 for getting this one. But for calculation we will use our original pattern 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1, and then we will calculate. But we know that for both the these two cases, okay, these two cases are this one. For this one we have to get what? 1 1. So if it calculate that, then you will get 1 1 for these two cases. That means by just selecting theta greater than equal to 1 or y greater than equal to 1, we'll be able to separate out these two cases from rest of the two inhibitory conditions. Hence, whatever weight we have assumed, that is v1 is equal to v2 equal to 1, that is what proper. So then finally we can draw this particular graph where you can show properly all the weights. This question is very, very important, and most of the time they ask this question. So please try to practice this particular question. And if you see here, all the weights are 1, right? All the weights are 1 except those cross weights which are -1 is there. Okay, and all the weights are 1.
So can you show that condition where we took v1 and v2 as 1?
V1, V2, we took 1. What are you asking?
So at 0, 1 and 1, 0, both places we are getting y as 1, right?
Yeah.
And in when 1 and 1, both x1 and x2, sorry, z1 and z2 are 1, how did we get y as 0?
So that 1 1 is x1 x2, but we are calculating the values with respect to 0 0, so that is correct, but we are comparing the values as compared to x1 and x2,
right? So we are not taking these values exactly input. We are taking the x1 x2 pattern, this pattern, okay, these x1 and x2, the original pattern we are taking, right?
Okay.
These Z1 and Z2 are just the simply intermediate thing, right? So we will not apply them. We are applying what actual the input patterns 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, and when we are calculating on that. But we know that for these two middle condition we should get what firing condition. So that means for 0 1 and 1 0 actually, okay, we should get the firing condition.
Okay, got it.
Yeah. So this is now let's see once more entire thing. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me. Yeah, so normally this question is asked for 10 marks, and they will simply give you implement XOR function using McCulloch-Pitts neuron. They may change this particular thing, consider binary data or bipolar data. So we can always draw the truth table, and then we can draw the graph. And then we can say that this is not linearly separable, hence one intermediate layer is required. And then finally you can tell that the combination circuit, this one, and then you can say that y is equal to z1 plus z2, where z1 is what, x1 x2 bar, and z2 x1 bar x2, and final y will be z1 or z2. So these three functions one by one we'll be solving for z1, then z2, and then y, the entire z1 or z2. So only one thing you will have to remember, that for calculation of the last one table, you don't have to select the patterns of Z1, Z2, right? You will have to take the patterns of X1 and X2 only. So the first circuit, the entire circuit is like this. Since we have included this particular layer, the middle layer, so what we are doing from the X1 and X2, we are trying to connect both the neurons, right? So give the proper weights assumption according to that. So W11, W12, W21, and W22. And then from the middle layer, we are giving the input reward to the Y output neuron. And let's say we are connected with V1 and V2. So we will first solve this Z1 function, then Z2 function, and then the final one. So when we will try to solve this Z1 function, we will always see that to Z1 function which different inputs are coming, okay, that is important. So which different inputs are coming? W11 is coming, W21 is coming, and X1 is coming from here, X2 is coming from here. So we will have to draw that particular circuit only. So first draw the table of Z1 is equal to x1 x2 bar, right, and check for which particular condition there is a firing condition. For 1 0 there is a firing condition, draw that particular circuit, only that part circuit. where Z1 is connected to X1 by W11 and X2 by W21. Write the formula and then try to calculate. First, you can assume weights like W11 equal to W2 equal to 1. And then you can check whether you are getting the proper output. So for the third condition, you should get what? Firing condition. But for the third one, we are getting 1. For the second one, also 1 and 0 and 2 is there. So we are clearly seeing that we are not able to separate it out by the first weights. So we will going to change the weight because our assumption is not right. So first weight we are taking W1, W21 we are taking as -1. Then we will try to calculate and we will check that the rest all the weights are less than equal to 0. Only this firing condition is what greater than equal to 1. So by choosing proper threshold that is greater than equal to 1, we are easily separate it out. Okay, first part is solved. Then second part we can take this one in the similar fashion. We can show the circuit, we can assume the weights and we can proceed and we can calculate it. And then finally we will see that W12 when we will choose -1, W22 equal to 1, and the theta we can take greater than equal to 1, we can easily separate it out. And then the final third function where y is equal to z1 or z2 we can take, and then we can calculate this one, and both the weights v1 and v2 we can assume 1, and then we will get the proper separation for middle two cases, and then the final circuit will be this one. Okay. So any doubt in this, all of you? So one thing what I am seeing, this is neural network nodes, but it's only 39 pages. So this is end of my nodes of neural network. I'll have to see because this is only the, I mean, in the initial part, this node is there. I'll have to check with any BE student. So if I'll get the nodes. Let me check this one. No, this is evenly. It's 55 pages. Okay. Ah, yeah. In this is there. Okay, the second part is there. No problem. Okay. So till here, clear all of you? Then after that we can start with the different learning algorithms, and then we can solve one by one all the learning algorithm, because the problem based on all the learning algorithm is there. So we don't know on which particular learning algorithm they will going to ask. They keep on saying that now we don't ask in so much deep, but we don't know if any problem will come on any learning algorithm, so we will have to learn it. There is no choice. So now we can start. Okay. So all of you just concentrate over here. So we are having different neural networks algorithms or learning algorithms or learning rules, okay? So the three different categories are there, like supervised, unsupervised, and reinforced. Supervised is based on the error, so it's called as error-based, right? Unsupervised, there we don't calculate error over there, but in reinforced, it is output-based. Now, in that, different rules we have classified. So if you see here in the supervised, we are having perceptron learning first. Then we are having gradient descent. In gradient descent, we are having first basic delta, then the second withdraw half. This is also called as LMS. Then the third one is back propagation. In the gradient descent only, the third one is back propagation. And then the third is what? Stochastic. In stochastic, we are having stimulated annealing. or example is given Boltzmann learning rule. So just note down this one, this all categories, and then we'll be learning one by one. So the third one is stochastic, that is stimulated annealing. And in the unsupervised, if you see, first one we are having Hebbian learning, and second we are having competitive learning. It's in competitive learning, we will see what winner take all learning, winner takes all learning, winner takes all learning. And reinforced learn is output based. This is not there in your syllabus, only two are there, and the learning algorithm based on these two are there. So we'll be concentrating on all these algorithms based on supervised and unsupervised learning. So please make a note of this classification. Finished.
Yes, sir.
Archana, today I think Mandar is not there, so you can give me attendance, okay, later. Which way is the present roll numbers are there?
Sure, sir.
Okay. So let's see this one. Perceptron learning. Just all of you draw this graph. Okay, I'll just copy this. Okay, so if you see here, there is one node, and to this four inputs are there, x1, x2, xj and xn. Okay, so you can, if you want, you can put here dot dot, right? And here also three dots. Then the x1 is connected to this particular neuron by wi1, this is wi2, 1j. So this you can say in this way also. See, there are two notation. So either you take the node ka first value and then the input ka first value, or you take the input ka first value and then the node ka first value. So in this, if you see that this particular notation is taking in this way, that it's taking first the node ka, this is net, I mean this node is what I, let's say. So So it's taking first the subscript of that one and then the input ka. So the normal way we follow the first one and then this one. So it's up to you. This is taken from Zurada book. So the Zurada books follows the another notation that it takes first the node ka and then it will take the input ka, subscript. Anyway, so the idea is we are giving the inputs to this particular neuron and then the total net input we will be calculating. Okay, the normal way we will calculate the net input, how we calculate by simple formula w1x1 plus w2x2 in that way, right? Then after calculation of that net, we will give to some function, okay, to get the output of the neuron. We substitute inside a function, right? So after substituting inside the function, we will get some output, and this is what the output, that is OI. Clear? So in short, what we do, if this is a neuron, okay, all these inputs are there and we want to get the output. So here we will first do what? Wx summation of all. And then after that, this net, we'll going to substitute inside a function. So f of net, we will calculate. And this will give us the output. Okay? So that is OI. So if from the ith neuron I am getting the output, I am saying this output will be OI. Now from that output, since this perceptron learning falls under which category? This perceptron learning falls under what? Supervised learning. If you see here, it's supervised learning. The first one is what? Perceptron learning. So perceptron learning will be what? Error based. So supervised means what? We will do this. I mean, supervisor will be there. So the error calculation will be done and it will be fed to the input, right? And every time the output and the actual output, desired output and the actual output will be observed. What is the difference between that? And then based on that, the error will be calculated. So if you see here, this output which we are getting, this is called as what? Actual output. So this is my actual output. There are two outputs. This is my actual output. And this output which I am giving, this is my desired. Okay. This is what? Desired. So whatever we will calculate, that will be actual, and desired we can give. So after processing everything, after substituting inside the function, we are getting this actual output. But the desired is this one. If you see, the actual is what? It's connected to this particular summation part by the minus sign. That means he, and this one is with the plus sign. That means it will calculate DI minus OI. Okay. It will calculate what? DI minus OI. So DI minus OI is what? It's an error signal. Right? Error signal. It's an error. Error between what? The desired signal. I want desired signal as A. But actual output I am getting as what? B, right? So there is a difference between these two. So that's what is the difference that we are calculating. So difference can always be calculated by a desired signal minus the actual output. So DI minus OI. This I am giving input to where? This multiplier. So in this multiplier, we will give the X input also. Okay, whatever total X inputs are there, that we will give. So this X denotes what? All these inputs actually, right? So these are X inputs we will give, and we will give this particular DI minus OI, and we will going to also multiply by one constant that is called as C. This C is what? A learning constant. Okay, C is what? A learning constant. Yeah, so C is one of the learning constant. C is there. Then this basically we denote it by symbol R, learning signal. Okay, R is given as what? DI minus OI, the difference between desired signal and the actual output. Okay, and then the X is your total X input pattern. Okay, so your X may have like the patterns like this, 1 1 0 1, like this the patterns it may have. So this is your X. Now so whole formula, why we are calculating? Basically we are calculating this to update the weights. Okay, so whatever the initial weight is there, we will get the actual output. Then we saw that there is a difference between actual output and desired output, and then by using some formula we are trying to calculate the change in weights. Change in weights is given by delta W. Okay, so if for ith neuron I'm calculating, where is the 5 minutes? So for ith neuron, if I am calculating for ith neuron, so that will be denoted as what? Delta wi. Okay, delta wi. So delta wi or the delta w formula is what? Delta w formula is what? Remember, delta w formula is crx. CRX. This is a formula, remember, for change in weight formula is what? CRX, where R is given by what? DI, where R is given by what? DI minus OI. Okay, where R is, yes. Where R is what? DI minus OI. Okay, so this we will have to remember. Now I am giving the change in weight delta WI to this particular neuron again. And after that, after changing the weights, after updating the weights, again I'll try to calculate the actual output, this OI, right? And suppose again I'm finding any difference between the desired signal and the actual output, then we will calculate DI minus OI. Again, we will try to calculate delta WI. Again, we will going to update the weights. Then again, we will find out the actual output. So this process will go on until we will get our desired output. So this is how we try to calculate it. Okay, so now for perceptron learning, you can remember, the type of learning is what? Supervised. Type of architecture is what? It's a feed forward architecture. We are giving the inputs and then we are going in the forward direction for the calculations. Output it will going to produce, that will be either, I mean, binary or the discrete activation function. So it will be binary. Okay, it will be binary. So the output will be in the ones and zero format. So till here everything is clear. Perceptron learning rule, it's in the supervised learning. So supervisor will be there. We'll try to calculate the error. We will try to update weights in every step. And then again, we will calculate the actual output and the difference between the DI minus OI. The learning signal R is given by what? DI minus OI. Change in weights formula is what? Delta W, you can remember, CRX, where R is given as what? DI minus OI or D minus OI. Okay. So we'll see in the next lecture the problems based on this perceptron learning. Any doubt in this, all of you? And all of you can give your attendance also, so that Archana can mark it and then she will forward to me. So I'll Archana, whether it's done?
Sir, just 1 minute.
Okay.
Yes, sir, it's done.
Okay. If nobody is there, then I'll terminate this. Okay, thank you, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.